Welcome to Crafting with Louisa. I'm Louisa and today I've got an envelope mini album to show you. And it uses, I think it's A6 size envelopes. So, and it's got pockets in here. So all these are pockets. I'm going to show you how to do this today. There are a few changes I'm going to make, which I'll explain. So all these are all pockets in here, and there's six envelopes, but also it folds out. It's not going to fit in the camera, but it folds out flat ways there. So you've got pockets there, and then on the other side it's just some mats I've used. You could make these into pockets. I've just done them as mats in my two. Put your photos or journal or whatever. And I should preface this with the fact that this isn't my idea. I saw it on Pinterest, just of how you put the envelopes together. They didn't do any matting or anything, but I thought it looked nicer with that. So this one I've used Stamping Up cardstock and Stamping Up Designer Series paper. The one I'm going to show you, I'm just going to use Stamping Up cardstock, and I've got a different paper that I've found, and I'll put a link for that as well. So we're going to do this. So what you'll need first is six envelopes. I'm using A6 envelopes, but you could adapt this to anything. So you're going to open these up, and what we're going to do is we're just going to glue them like that all the way along, and that's going to be a pocket, and then we're going to mat them. So I've used wet glue because I'm going to mat both sides. If you were just going to mat the one side with the pocket, I would use some double-sided sticky tape, you know, this kind of stuff, because it looks a lot neater. You can see the glue and stuff when you do it this way, but because I'm going to mat it, and it is quicker. So you're just going to put glue there. Just along here. I suppose you could lick this, but I'd still put glue on it. And I'm going sparingly with the glue. You know, I'm scraping it on, but I'm getting quite a good coverage. And you want to try and not go right up to the score line. You just want to go just up to the score line, because obviously you want these to fold. And you want it lined up as much as you can at the top there. And the good thing about this glue, it does give you a minute just to dry it down. So that's what you're going to do. So the next one is going to go there. I'll leave a link for the Pinterest post that I found this on. Because I wanted to do an envelope mini album, but I didn't really want to faff around with all the proper binding and stuff. So when I saw this, because I'm not, you know, haven't done any mini any envelope mini albums before, so I wanted something that was a bit easy to start with. And this is, you know, you could put as many as you wanted in. I'm just doing six. Any glue just keeps it out of the way. And get these as even as you can on the bottom. So I'm going to do that with all six envelopes. And then they're going to fold up. They're going to fold like that, like a Z. So I'm going to do the rest, and I'll meet you back when I've done that. Ages. So they're literally just gonna fold up like this. So the covers, front cover's gonna go there and the back cover's gonna go there. So what we need to do is we need to map these. So I've got, you'll need 10 pieces because you're doing 6 on this side. Oh, let me just put my, be very naughty, I haven't put my pin in the top of my glue. So we've got, oh gosh, you can't see, but we've got 6 bits you want to map this side. And then we've just got 4 bits on the other side. So the paper I'm using comes from, and I'll leave a link to it. It is Wildflower by First Edition Papers, and it's gorgeous. It's got some textures in, like a canvas texture, and some that are a bit pearlescent, and then it's got has got some double-sided paper at the back. So that's what I'm going to use. So you will need 10 pieces. Oh, and I've got the cover there. 10 pieces of paper, 6 inches by 4 1/4. So you'll need those. So, and we're literally, they're literally just going to be stuck here, but we're not going to stick it on this side, so you've got a pocket. And actually what I didn't do on this one, which a friend pointed out, is I should have just notched a bit out here, so it's a bit easier to get into. So that's what I'm going to do first. A round punch. I don't even know what size this is. I think it's about an inch. Yeah, about an inch. Not that it matters, but just go in and get it. You know, you want to do it in the middle of that bit, and then you want to do about half the circle. So you've got that. So when you map that, you've got a bit, and also people then will know that it's a pocket. So I'll go and do that with all of these, and I'll be back. Put these on here. Rather than glue the back, I'm going to glue on the envelope bit, because obviously I don't want to. I obviously don't want to glue up here, because then I'll be sealing the shut, which in this instance wouldn't be very helpful. I've just used a wet glue because it's quick and it's easy, and I think it's perfectly strong enough. But if you want to use your double-sided tape, and I haven't put a lot of glue on, I've covered a lot of area, but I haven't put loads on because it'll just ooze out. So this is the first one I'm going to do, and I just think that's such gorgeous paper, and it just went so well with our Emerald Envy from Stamping Up, and I think the other colour that I'm using is, oh gosh, what's it called now? Rich Raspberry, I think, is the other colour that I'm using. So you're just going to do that all along, and plan it out nicely. So I might want to put, maybe not one that's, because that's, see, that's got a bit of shimmer to it. So I might want to put a plain one next to that. I think I'll go for that one. So you're just going to do this all the way along. So I will do this and come back when I've done that. That's what we've got so far. I've got a little pockets on the front. I need a wide angled camera, don't I? And our maps on the back. So, I'm obviously not very good at getting glue around the edges. So, it's gonna fold like this. To go that way, and that one to go that way. So then our cover is gonna sit here, which is why I haven't covered that. Because that's where the cover's going. So, we'll set that aside, and then you've got your pockets there. And I would definitely do some kind of notch there. So, we'll set that aside for now, and we'll get on with the cover. Yay. So, you will need 2 bits of RTC's a cereal box, but back of our paper packs, perfect for that sort of thing. And they need to be 7 by 5 3/4. And then you'll need 2 pieces, because these are going to wrap around, 2 pieces of cardstock. I've used our Emerald Envy. And you need 2 bits, 8 by 5 3/4. And I will put all the measurements and stuff on the blog post, so you don't have to remember them now. So I'll just stick my sticky notes over there so that I can remember them for the blog. I really ought to get a notepad. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to put some double-sided tape. The wider the better, probably, but this is all I've got, so. And I want it to go right to the edge. And we'll do some in the middle as well. So the same. Done all my tape, and I like to really burnish that down, because it's a lot easier. Well, apart from anything, you get a really good bond, but it's a lot easier to take the backing off it as well. And the other thing you could use for this is matte board for picture framing, if you've got that. I mean, these are great, but they're not the strongest. But you know, normal wear and tear, you'd be fine. So, to go along and peel off the backing. I should. And put these straight in the bin. Because otherwise, you will have a desk full of curly little bits of paper or whatever they are on the back here. So yes, that's some free advice for you. Okay, so peel before the backing. And I really would use sticky tape, I wouldn't use wet glue. So you've got your cover, which I can't remember if I said the size, which is 8 by 5.5. Oh no, 5 3/4, I think. So you basically want an inch bigger than whatever your mat board is. So I've got fluff on here. So part of my head if it gets in the way, but just you want to line that up as evenly as you can, which I haven't done. It's too late now. That is really annoying. I haven't done that evenly at all. Never mind. Bone folder. You just want to score on that outside edge. Just up along that chipboard and then turn it over and just really score that in. The reason why I've done that up to the edge, you can either use this or you could grab your little ball stylus and go up, but you literally just want to go up, just otherwise it might crack. So you can eyeball this if you want, but what you want to do next is get a 45 degree angle or thereabouts, and you want about an eighth of an inch between. I might not be able to see that. Oops. Let's see. Sometimes you can't tell on this little monitor. Oh yes, you can see that. So can you see that line there? It's about an eighth of an inch from that corner. If you go too close, it won't be covered. So do that on all four sides and then I'll come back to you. You can see that line there? And then we're going to put tape on this, and I don't know where my tape's disappeared to. Oh, it's there. So I like to, we're going to cut on those lines. You can either cut now and then put tape on, or put tape on and cut now. So I want to put my tape right up to the edge. And then you can, along with some scissors. And we want to cut along that line that we marked. You can eyeball this if you want. Just snip that away. What I'm going to do is I like to just tease that up. Just encourage that to go. Just like that. Let's peel these off. Okay, and then you want to put a bit zoomed in. Oh, trying to zoom you out and I'm zooming you in. Oh gosh. Sorry about that. So you want to start at the bottom and just massage it over because you don't want a bubble in it. So just to do that, so you get it nice and smooth. And then we'll do the opposite side. Peel it off. just massage that in and eat it. So you can see now why it's quite important to do that score line. Encourage it in. And then what you can do is with your bone folder, sieve it in that corner just so it won't flop over. Okay. I think I've done a bit too much. So peel that off. And just pull that over. I've got a bit of a funny edge there, but I'm not too bothered by that. And then peel that off. As soon as you get the camera on, everything seems to take so long to do. Do it quickly and then. So what I would do then is really burnish that now, because you want a really good strong bond. And do it on the other side, and that's one cover. So then you'll need that's the outside cover. You will need two inside covers, 6.5 by 4.5. Six and a half by 4.25, and that's just gonna sit in there. And I would maybe do it a little bit bigger, but I cut it wrong. And I thought, I'm not going to cut all that, I'll use it. So there's a warning. So it's just gonna sit like that. So